Hey guys, Smash, Smash Strength Lab. I'm here today to discuss why personal training and strength coaching is so important to me. I think it really all falls down to I just love what I do. I've loved training since I was a young man and all throughout college. Exercise science has basically saved my life many times over, and I love sharing that with people. I love helping people get in better shape. And the way I break it down to people is that everyone needs a coach. At one point in life, you had that person that was a mentor to you to help you be successful. Look back at high school. You had great teachers. You had great coaches in gym class. Maybe you had somebody that really inspired you or motivated you. That's what I see myself of as a strength coach and a personal trainer. I help people get in better shape. And I think a lot of people have personal training confused nowadays because a lot of personal trainers today are looked at like slave drivers and guys that push you through a workout. Either they're number counters and they put you on a machine and, you know, you do a certain number of reps or sets and, you know, hey, that's it for the day. And how I try to separate myself out differently is I want to get into your lifestyle. I want to learn about you. I want to learn what makes you tick and how to motivate you better. And also find out what you really want, your big why. Why do you want to train? Why do you want to get better? And that's the thing. It's like a true coach will get into your personal life and figure out what is motivating you to do a particular thing, whether it's, you know, you want to do a physique show or you want to get stronger or you just want to simply move better. And that's really the job of the coach, is to kind of identify with that person and feel them out and see what they truly need as a person, and then adapt that into a training program that's individual and suited for them to get them to their goals. Now, and hands down, most training programs are going to be very much the same. About 80 to 90% of the training programs are going to be the same stuff. The 10 to 20% variance is where you really make your money in for that particular person, whether you got a person with lower back problems, you got a person with hip problems, shoulder problems. Those are issues that a good coach needs to address and say, hey, you know, this is what we need to do here. We need to stay out of this area, go into more of this area. Refer out to a good ART or a chiro or a physio to kind of work with them and get that person better so that they can move better and feel better overall. And here's the big takeaway from a lot of personal trainers out there is that they want to bring their clients in and just beat the piss out of them. Every single time they come to the gym, it's like pound, pound. And we don't want to do that with people. That's the wrong approach. I see this happening all the time. I've left gyms before because they wanted me to do that. And, you know, it's fine if you have a client that likes to be pushed, but sometimes your job as a coach is more of a, oh, you need to slow down versus a, hey, let's speed up. And at times, there's benefits to speeding up and slowing down. A good coach needs to know how to manipulate those training variables for each individual person. If you have somebody that's super stressed out, chronically wound up tight, maybe it's time to do a little bit more mobility, slow things down a little bit, get some heavy weight training in there, but keep the pace moderate and just kind of let that person ease into it. Because overall, we want a person to get better. We want their performance to improve. We want their strength to improve. We want their body comp to go down or whichever way we're trying to go, whether we're trying to gain muscle mass or lose body fat, whatever that person needs. So a good coach will identify those issues. They'll do an assessment to figure out where their client is or what their client needs, and then they'll try to push them into those areas in order to improve. Poor personal training coaches do not do this. They just give everyone the same templated program, and one program is not necessarily suited for everyone. So there's always a little bit of a unique variance and little bits of tweaks along the way. And there's nothing that says that, you know, somebody has to do a particular exercise or what. Most coaches will flow into a certain parameter of their training style, and that's fine. But they need to realize that their workouts are not their clients' workouts, and not everyone needs to be pushed into the ground. Remember, we're trying to get people better. And this is what personal training should be. This is what we try to do here at Smash the Strength. We want to take you in as an individual, see what you can do, where you're at, do an assessment, see where your limitations and contraindications are, and work around those issues to make you a better, fitter person overall. At the end of the day, I want my clients leaving feeling like they got a good, solid workout. They worked hard, maybe not too hard for one particular day, and they feel good. I want them coming back going, yeah, I'm ready to fucking train, let's go. And that is what we want out of personal training. This is how we separate ourselves out from the rest of the pack. All right, thanks for watching. Personal training, check it out. Smash the strength button.